Hello everyone, and welcome to the first State of VR on August 2020. This will be a recurring segment where I will be updating you all on some of the cool new things happening in VR. So without further ado, let's jump in. If you've been following VR-related news for a while, you know that there are many companies out there trying to develop alternative methods of locomotion for use in VR. We've seen omnidirectional treadmills, special shoes that allow you to run while seated, and some add-on clips that work with you running in place. Well, now there's a new player in town that's sort of trying to combine all of the above into one solution. Enter EKTOVR, calling themselves world's first robotic movement solution. The shoes made by EKTO work by slowly rolling the player back to the center of their play space while they're walking. This ensures that the player will never run into any walls. Current prototypes are shown with players walking in a casual pace, but the hope is that the future will also bring running support to the shoes. In other news, PlayStation VR has been out for a while now, and has provided Sony with a serious response to Oculus's growing market share. While the initial PSVR headset was a bit limited in terms of FOV, image quality, and input options, the platform has had no shortage of AAA quality games like Resident Evil, Blood and Truth, and RMNVR. With the PS5 coming out later this year, most gamers are then expecting Sony to also be coming with an update to its PSVR system, and they might just get their wish. First discovered by Let's Go Digital, it appears that in March this year, Sony filed a patent with the World Intellectual Property Office for an input device. The input device does look a whole lot like the Valve Knuckle controllers, and if they get it released, would be a huge step forward for the PSVR ecosystem. Now, I know that patents do not necessarily mean that the mentioned product will also go into production, but the named input device itself would make a lot of sense for an updated PSVR offering. It has been said before that it will be unlikely for Sony to announce a new pricey PSVR alongside an already expensive new PlayStation release, so the earliest date to expect this by would be late 2021. HP announced that its upcoming Reverb G2 headset will be shipping in early November to those who pre-ordered, and that new pre-orders will be shipping somewhere in December. Alongside this announcement, HP also announced that they will be forming a few last-minute design changes, which will hopefully make the headset that much more awesome. The lenses have been improved to reduce reflections and improve clarity. The menu button on the controllers have gotten a more pronounced shape so users can distinguish from the other Windows button by touch. Now included with the headset will also be a full-size to mini display port adapter and a USB-C to USB-A adapter. Finally, HP says that they managed to improve the low persistence of the display, but that as a trade-off, the headset will now be needed to plug in to a separate power outlet. If you're big on PC VR and haven't had a look at the device already, I really suggest you have a look. So if you've been in the market to buy a VR headset and are really keen on getting the best image quality possible on your screen, the Interior Wood of the VR Tech channel has got you covered. Using a camera to film through the lenses of the headset, he's made a vast overview of most headsets on the market to see how their image quality stacks up in common VR use cases. Posted on Reddit, you can see this image, which should give you a rough overview of which headset to narrow down your search for. If you hadn't heard of his channel yet, then I suggest you check him out. Link to his comparison video can be found in the description down below. The popular alternate app store for the Quest platform has been on the good end of the news cycle, as reportedly they have managed to gather investments in the sum of $650,000. One of the investors was none other than Oculus's own founder, Palmer Luckey. Luckey, who has invested in a number of VR startups since leaving Facebook and Oculus behind, said that SideQuest was following in the footsteps of the earlier Oculus vision. Luckey was quoted saying, "No HMD manufacturer should have a stranglehold on the VR ecosystem or unilateral control over what people run on their VR headsets. And when I look at SideQuest, I see the spirit of Oculus shared." SideQuest has mentioned that the new funding will help to hire more developers, a community manager, and a designer, all of which will hopefully help provide us with more amazing content in the future. So that's all for this video. I'm very excited about SideQuest receiving so much positive attention, since they've already provided the VR community with so much amazing content that I really couldn't do without. So which stories have gotten your attention, and what do you think about the investment in SideQuest? Let me know in the comments down below. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, be sure to do so to stay up to date with more amazing content, and also make sure to hit that bell icon for notifications. Make sure to smash the like button if you haven't already, and I will see you guys next time.